how to find running total or cumulative total in Power BI. Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are we going to learn in this video? We are going to understand how to calculate the running total or cumulative total using DAX functions in Power BI. So before directly taking you into the technical part of Power BI, let me just briefly explain you why this particular calculation is required or why it is in demand. So if you have attended or if you are planning to attend any interviews related to Power BI in the future, then this is the trending question that is being asked most of the times, though you are a fresher, though you are an experienced professional. So when I'm talking about the word called cumulative, when I'm talking about the word called running total, okay, it is very easy to understand. First, let me show you the data, explain you the data, then let me tell you why and how this result is in the output. So if you carefully look into this particular table, I have three columns here. I have column called name, I have column called number, and I have column called date where years are mentioned in it. So what this cumulative total or running total will do is nothing but, if I calculate this running total, first result will be 5 itself, then the 5 including the name B, the value is 10, right? So 5 plus 10, 15 will be the result for B. So if I talk to you about the result C, B value is 15, right? 15 plus 15, the C value will be 30. So whichever it is having the next consecutive number, to that particular number, this value will be added. So here we will use some 3 to 4 DAX functions. So please listen and understand it very carefully, because this is the most demanding question which is being asked nowadays in any interview that we go. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to take a new measure. So before taking a new measure, let me take all these values in a column, in a table. So I'm choosing a table here. In this table, let me add the name, then let me add the date, and then let me add the number. Okay, so I have got these. Let me increase the size of this one. So I'm increasing the value size to bold, and I'm making the size to 16, and I'm coming back to the column header. I'm increasing the value to bold, and I'm just increasing the size so that it can be clearly, easily understandable. Okay, so now if you carefully observe, the complete total, of the numbers is 275. Am I right? So now I'm choosing a new measure. So I am taking a new measure now, and in this new measure, I am writing my running total. I'm calculating my running total. Okay, so when you are calculating a running total, so first you should get an expression, what is the total value you have, which is 275. I'm getting this number when I have taken this number column in a visual, but how to find out that using a DAX? So for that, I am first using the calculate function. So as per the syntax, first we need to choose the expression. So here I will choose the total of the numbers. So as I do not have a readily available measure called total numbers, I am choosing the DAX function called sum here. Okay, sum of what is the column that I have to choose? Number. Okay, so I'll close the parenthesis, comma. Now what I'm going to do, I am going to choose the filter DAX function. So what this filter DAX function is doing, it will return a table that has been filtered. So the complete table it is going to give us in the output. So now it is telling me to choose the table name first, then I have to choose the expression for the filter. So what is our table name? Our table name itself is table. Am I right? Our table name itself is table, comma, what is the filter expression that we have to take? So as per the dates, I have to get the cumulative total for the numbers. As per the, each date, I have to get the running total. So here we will choose date. Okay, we will choose date that we have in our table. Table come date. So what I'm going to do now, here I am going to take less than or equal to. The reason that I am taking less than or equal to here is that as I have to get my first number from this number column and then I have to add it with my next number, right? So the number which is less than to that, right? As per our A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J names that we have and according to the date. So now what I am choosing the maximum function where I have to get the next maximum value of that particular number. So here, I am comparing it with the date related information. I will go with the table called date. Alright, so what I am doing, I am closing the parenthesis for the maximum function. Then I am closing the parenthesis for filter function. Then I am closing the parenthesis for sum function, right? So calculate function. So now I am clicking on enter. Let us get the new measure into our table and let us verify that what we are expecting, what we want in the output, did we really get that or not? So I am getting my running total here in the table. If you see this very carefully, my dear viewers, 5, 5, 10, 10, 15, 15, 20, 20, 25, 25, we got exactly the same answers. We got exactly the same numbers. We did not get anything new here. We have got the same value, same as a number. Am I right? So what are we expecting? We are expecting that the first value 5 should be 5 itself. And this 5 should get added with this 10 to get 15 here. And this 15 should get added with the next maximum number, which is 15. Then I have to get 30 here. Then this 30 should get added with the next number 25. Then I have to get 55 here. So that is the result I'm expecting. The reason that I have not got the result that I want, the reason is that I have chosen the filter function. That's fine. But what this filter is doing, it is giving us the complete result, the table as a filter, returning as a filter, right? So now I have to mention to the Power BI, I have to specify that I want to choose the entire table, all, I have to choose all here, all as a DAX function. So what it is doing, it returns all the rows in a table, it returns all the rows in a table and all the values in a column by ignoring any filter if it is applied, okay? All, then I have to keep this table name, which is table, under this all, so that it will consider all the informations by ignoring any filter if I have applied in this particular table. Now if I click on enter, please check the answer here. So see this 5, it is added with 10, we got 15. This 15, it got added with 15, we got 30. This 30, we got added with 20, we got 50. This 50 added with 25, we got 75. 75 added with 30, we got 105. And this 105 added with 35, we got 140. And this 140 added with 40, we got 180. And this 180 added with 445, we got 225. And this 225 added with 50, we got 275. Okay. So this is the running total that we have got it. That is the running total we have got it. So please make sure that we have used calculate function. We have used sum function. We have used filter function. We have used all function. We have used max function. 5 DAX functions we have used to calculate our running total or cumulative total using a new measure in Power BI. So this question is most frequently asked in any interviews nowadays. So practicing this kind of example will be really helpful for you to answer this type of question that if you have or if you get it in an interview in the future. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.